Hello students. Till now we have seen so many things in the topic of motion. Okay, for example, what is motion, rest, distance, displacement, speed, average speed. Your last class we have discussed velocity. Your last class we have seen speed and velocity. So you again recall from speed and velocity, isn't it? Okay, first one, what is speed, sir? Okay, what is speed? Speed means nothing but it's very easy one. The distance covered by an object. Okay, the distance covered by an object per unit time. That is speed. But what is velocity, sir? Velocity means nothing but the displacement covered by an object. Displacement covered by an object per unit time. That is what is that? That is velocity. Here the speed depends on what is that? Speed only depends on how fast or how slow the object is moving. But speed does not specify particular direction. Speed does not specify particular direction. But velocity, what is velocity, sir? Speed with direction. Okay, here the velocity depends on both speed as well as direction, isn't it? Here the velocity depends on how fast or how slow the object is moving in particular direction. Isn't it? In particular direction, towards only one direction, that is velocity. It's very easy. So next one, the unit of speed and velocity. What is the unit of speed? Unit of speed, that is meter per second. Okay, the unit of velocity, that is also meter per second. The both speed as well as velocity, unit same, but concept different. Okay, there is some dissimilarities. Both are not equal, both are not similar, isn't it? There is some dissimilarities, isn't it? It's very simple. So speed means what is that? Speed means distance covered by an object per unit time. Velocity, displacement covered by an object per unit time, isn't it? So speed unit meter per second as well as velocity unit also, that is meter per seconds, isn't it? Speed, whether it is vector quantity or scalar quantity. Okay, already we know speed does not display particular direction. But it has magnitude. It has only magnitude. So speed under the category of what is that? It's a scalar quantity, because speed has only magnitude. There is no direction. Next, velocity. Velocity, whether it is vector quantity or scalar quantity. Velocity is a vector quantity. Why, sir? Why? Because it has both magnitude as well as direction. Both magnitude as well as direction. Okay, for example, a train moves 25 km per hour speed towards this direction. Here 25 km per hour, okay, that is speed towards this direction, that is direction. Okay, specifies particular direction, towards only particular direction, isn't it? So it has both magnitude as well as direction, that's why it's under the category of vector quantity, isn't it? So speed is a scalar quantity as well as velocity is a vector quantity. Speed tells us how fast or how slow the object is moving. It doesn't specify particular direction. But velocity tells us how fast or how slow the object is moving in particular direction. Okay, towards specific direction. Isn't it? It's a very easy one. Okay, even last class we have discussed uniform velocity and non-uniform velocity also. What is uniform and non-uniform velocity? Uniform, yeah, the timing units answer uniform, which means equal. Okay, an object covers equal distances. Okay, equal distances, equal interval of time. Okay, particularly, okay, which means towards only one direction, particular direction. That is uniform velocity. But in non-uniform velocity, an object covers unequal distances in equal interval of time. Okay, unequal distances in equal interval of time. That is known as towards particular direction. That is known as non-uniform velocity. So till now we have seen up to non-uniform velocity. So you again recall what is velocity. Velocity means nothing but the displacement covered by an object per unit time. What is per unit time? Every second. Okay, every second how much displacement is covered by an object. That is velocity. Isn't it? That is velocity. Okay, I'm going to write the definition for velocity on the board. Look at here. First one, velocity definition. Displacement covered by an object per unit time. unit time. Okay, that is called what is that? That is velocity. Amrit. So this is one of the definition. Okay, this is one of the definition for velocity. Okay, whereas we have another one definition that also you must know this. You must know that definition also. Okay. So I am going to write another one example. Sorry, another one definition for velocity on the board. Look at here. Rate of change of displacement. Is called velocity. Okay, here displacement word is very important. Okay, so another one definition. Okay, another one definition for velocity, the rate of change of displacement. Okay, the rate of change of displacement is called velocity. This is another one definition for velocity. First definition, the displacement covered by an object per unit time. Okay, per unit time, that is velocity. This is first definition. Another one definition you must know that. That is the rate of change of displacement is called velocity. What is that, sir? What is that word mean? Rate of change of. That is a new word to you. Am I right? Yes. What is the rate of? The rate of change of. What is the meaning, sir? Rate of change of mean nothing but how much? Okay, how much that quantity changes over time? Okay, how much that quantity changes over time? That is rate of change of. Okay, that is rate of change of. The quantity changes over time. Okay, the rate of change of, the word meaning, okay, note this point, very easy one. Rate of change of, that word meaning, the how much that quantity changes over time. Here, what quantity changes? Okay, in velocity, what quantity changes actually? Displacement changes. Displacement also one of the quantity. Yes, am I right? So displacement is one of the quantity here. How much the displacement changes over time? Okay, over time. That is velocity. Very simple one. See, look at here. Both definition meaning same. You don't get confusion. Okay, so both definition meaning same. You don't get confusion. Very easy one. Okay, we can write. Okay, in the way of first one. Okay, as well as second one. Both are same. Okay, both meaning same, but definition different, isn't it? So another one definition for velocity, that is rate of change of displacement is called, what is that? That is velocity. What is the word meaning rate of change of? Rate of change of means nothing but how much that quantity changes over time. Okay, with respect to time, how much that quantity changes? Here what quantity? What quantity changes in velocity? Displacement quantity changes, isn't it? Displacement quantity changes in velocity. So here, how much the displacement changes with respect to time or over time, that is velocity. Very easy. Okay, so both definition same. Okay, both definition meaning same, isn't it? You don't get confusion. Very similar, very easy. Okay, you can use this definition as well as this. Both are same. Okay, both definition meaning same, isn't it? Very simple. So speed, already we know speed is a scalar quantity. Speed is a scalar quantity as well as velocity is a vector quantity. Okay, velocity is a vector quantity. Okay. In some cases, the magnitude of the speed will be equal to magnitude of the velocity. How it is possible, sir? You may ask me, okay, how it is possible, sir? Because speed means what is that? Speed. Speed is a scalar quantity. But velocity is a vector quantity. Alright, speed is a scalar quantity, velocity is a vector quantity. Then how it is possible the speed of the magnitude will be equal to the magnitude of the velocity. Then how is that possible? Okay, in some cases, okay, note my word, not all the cases. In some cases, the magnitude of the speed will be equal to the magnitude of the velocity. Magnitude of the velocity. So today we will start with, today our class start with the differences between speed and velocity. As well as the magnitude of the speed will be equal to magnitude of the velocity. That is, okay, first we will see the magnitude. Okay, the first topic today, our topic is speed and velocity are equal in magnitude. Okay, today we'll start with next topic. Okay, so after non-uniform velocity, that is speed and velocity are equal in magnitude, not in direction, because speed tells us only how fast, how slow the object is moving. Speed does not specify particular direction, but velocity specify particular direction, isn't it? Velocity specify particular direction. Speed is a scalar quantity, vector velocity is a vector quantity, isn't it? So here, so even though the direction, okay, so direction is changing, as well as the quantity, vector quantity, scalar quantity changes. Okay, in particular case, okay, in some cases, the magnitude of the speed will be equal to the magnitude of the velocity. Okay, today we'll start with this topic. The speed and velocity are equal in only magnitude. Yes. So let's start with an example. Consider one boy. That boy standing there. That boy, the house is here. Consider one boy. Okay, that boy house is here. Okay, consider one boy. That boy standing here. Okay, very close to his house. That boy house is here. Okay, next one, fruit shop which is located towards east direction from his house here. What is this? This is fruit shop, isn't it? That is fruit shop. Okay, listen here, the crazy one, I recall that. Consider one boy, that boy standing here. Okay, so that boy standing here, very close to his house. That boy house is here. Then the one fruit shop which is located towards east direction. What direction? East direction. Towards east direction from his house. Okay, yes. The distance between that boy's house, okay, and the fruit shop, consider this is 100 meters. How much? 100 meters, isn't it? Yes. Here, that boy wants to buy some fruit. Okay, that boy wants to buy some fruit. Okay, for example, 2 kg orange. Okay, I like orange. Okay, that is the reason, right? Okay, 2 kg orange. Yes. That boy moves through the distance of 100 kilometers from his house to that food store. Am I right? Yes. Okay, here, that boy has taken 50 seconds. Consider 50 seconds, okay, to reach the fruit shop from his house, isn't it? Very easy one. Listen here, consider one boy, okay, that boy house is here, then one fruit shop which is located towards his direction, from his house, isn't it? The distance between that boy's house and the fruit shop, that is 100 meters, yes. Next, that boy wants to buy 2 kg orange, isn't it? 2 kg orange. So, that boy moves through the distance of 100 meters from his house to that fruit shop towards east direction. Which direction? Towards east direction, isn't it? Here, the distance specifies only what direction? Towards east direction. So, that is displacement, isn't it? That is a displacement, yes. Here, that boy covers the distance of 100 meters towards east direction from his house to fruit shop in 50 seconds. How much? 50 seconds, isn't it? Yes. Now you find out the distance and distance. Sorry. Now you find out the speed and velocity, isn't it? Now you find out the speed and velocity. Yes. First you find out speed. Okay. First one, that is speed. Yes. Speed. What is the speed? Speed is equal to what is that? Distance covered by an object over a time. Am I right? So we can write distance divided by time. Distance divided by time. Am I right? Yes. What is the distance here? Distance 100 meter. Distance how much? 100 meters. Yes, 100 meters. What is it? What is time taken? 15 seconds. So time, it is equal to 50 seconds. Okay, now substitute both value. Okay, in the formula of speed. So speed, which is equal to distance, how much? 100 meters. 100 meter divided by time taken, 50 seconds. 50 seconds. So what is the value? It is equal to 2. So speed of the boy, it is equal to 2 meter per second. Okay, isn't it? How much is the speed of that boy? The speed of the boy is equal to 2 meters per second. Okay, per second. So that is the speed of that boy. Am I right? Yes. Now we find out velocity. Now we find out the velocity. Second one, velocity. Second one, velocity. What is velocity, sir? What is velocity? Displacement covered by an object. Okay, displacement covered by an object per unit time. That is velocity. Yes. So velocity is equal to displacement divided by time taken. Time is. Okay. So what is displacement here? Displacement value how much? And time value how much? Okay. Listen here. Already we know what is displacement. Displacement is the shortest distance between initial point and final point. Am I right? Shortest distance between initial point and final point, that is displacement. Here this is initial point, which is final point. This is initial point and that is final point. Am I right? Here displacement is worth, what is it? How much? 100 meters. Am I right? Displacement is worth 100 meters towards what direction? Because displacement is a what? Displacement is a vector quantity. Okay, so velocity is a vector quantity. It has both magnitude as well as direction. So which specifies what direction? East direction. Isn't it? Yeah. So displacement 100 meters towards east direction. Towards east direction. Towards east. Isn't it? Yes. Then what is the time? Time quantity, how much? Time? Same 50 seconds. Same 50 seconds. Okay, now you find out the velocity value. So velocity is equal to displacement value 100 meters towards east. Substitute here 100 meters towards east divided by time value 50 seconds. 50 seconds. Okay, now we further divide both, we can get 2. Am I right? So velocity is equal to how much? So velocity is equal to 2 meters per second towards east. Towards east direction. Am I right? Towards east direction, look at that. So here the magnitude of the speed. The magnitude of the speed, which is equal to, okay, magnitude of the speed, which is equal to magnitude of the velocity. Isn't it? Yes. So speed value, that boy speed, how much? 2 meter per second. Okay, then velocity also say, which is equal to 2 meters per second. Am I right? So here, the magnitude of the speed, which is equal to magnitude of the velocity. Isn't it? Magnitude of the velocity. So the magnitude of the speed is equal to magnitude of the velocity. If the object, isn't it very important point? Look at here. If the object travels in a straight line, okay, single straight line. Okay, here the object moves only straight line. So whenever, note this point. So whenever an object moves single straight line, note this point.
single straight line,
okay, then the magnitude of the speed will be equal to magnitude of the velocity. Or the magnitude of the velocity will be equal to magnitude of the speed. Both are same, no problem. Isn't it?
So here this is a proof. The magnitude of the speed is equal to the magnitude of the velocity.
Okay, in which case, whenever an object moves, okay, in a single straight line. Okay, notice point, in a single straight line, then the magnitude of the speed will be equal to magnitude of the velocity. Isn't it? So this is a proof, very simple one. Okay?
Yes.
So next one, the magnitude of the speed, which is not always equal to the magnitude of the velocity. That is second case. So this is first case. In first case, the magnitude of the speed is equal to magnitude of the velocity. Okay, in second case, the magnitude of the speed is not always equal to the magnitude of the velocity. That is second case, we will see that.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, listen here.
So next case, what is this? Speed and velocity are not, what is point? Not always equal in magnitude. Okay, speed and velocity are not always equal in magnitude. Okay, in first case, speed and velocity are equal in magnitude. In second case, speed and velocity are not always equal in magnitude. That is second case. You keep this in your mind. Look at here. Consider same activity, same example. Okay, I can recall that. Okay, the one, consider one boy. Okay, that boy house is here. Then one food shop is located towards his direction. From his house. Isn't it? From his house. The distance between that boy's house and the food shop, that is 100 meters. Then look at here. That boy wants to buy some fruits. Isn't it? That boy moves. Okay, throw the 100-meter distance from his house to that food shop. Okay, that boy has taken 50 seconds. How much? 50 seconds to reach the fruit shop from his house. Isn't it?
Yes.
Isn't that boy? Now that boy is in fruit shop. Isn't it? Okay. Next note here. This is very important point. After buying the 2 kg of orange, again that boy moves along the same path of 100 meter from the fruit shop to his house. Okay, that boy's house. Isn't it? Look at here. Then after buying the fruit, okay, which means what fruit? 2 kg. That's 2 kg orange. Again that boy moves along the same path of 100 meter from the fruit shop. Okay, from the fruit shop to that boy's house. Okay, which means again that boy comes to same position. Original position. Now you find out the speed and velocity. Okay. First we will find what is that? Speed. Okay. Already we know speed, that is equal to distance covered by an object per unit time. Okay, mathematically we can write speed that is equal to distance divided by time. Am I right?
Yes.
What is the distance here? What is distance? You tell me, what is the distance?
Okay, so which means average distance, what is it? Sorry, average, what is average speed? What is average speed? So average speed is the difference between total distance and the total time taken. Alright, here what is the total distance, how much? First, listen here, first that boy starts his journey from his house. Okay, then after that boy comes to fruit shop. How much distance? 100 meters. Alright, 100 meters. Again, after buying, again that boy goes to his house. Okay, along the same path of the distance 100 meters, isn't it? So here 100 meter plus 100 meters is equal to how much? The total distance, that is 200 meters, isn't it?
Yes, the total. Total distance is equal to how much? 100 kilometer
plus 100 kilometers. First 100 kilometers for going fruit shop from his house. Then next 100 kilometers for going to his house from fruit shop, isn't it? So 100 kilometers from plus 100 kilometer, which is equal to how much? 200 kilometers. How much? Total distance 200 kilometers. Okay, yes. Then what is the time? So I'll write it here. Time is equal to how much? That boy has taken 50 seconds. Okay, 50 seconds to reach food shop from his house. I'm right, 50 seconds. Again that boy moves his same distance of 100 meters from the food shop to house. That here also that boy has taken same 50 seconds. How much? Same 50 seconds. So now what is the total time? Okay, 50 seconds plus 50 seconds. This is equal to how much? 100 seconds. Am I right?
Yes.
So total time is equal to 100 seconds. How much? 100 seconds. Now we find out the average speed. See, average speed and speed both are same. Okay, don't get confusion.
Yes.
So here average speed, which is equal to what is it? Total distance covered by an object divided by total time taken. How much total distance? Total distance how much? That is 200 kilometers. So 200 kilometer divided by what is this? Time, total time how much? 100 seconds. 100 seconds. Now what is the average speed? Average speed that is equal to how much? Is equal to 2. So 2 kilometer per seconds. Okay, sorry. A meter. Okay, here. Meter, not a kilometer, meter. Meter, I have taken only meter. You change the meter. Only meter. Okay, so here how much? The speed how much? 2 meter per seconds. How much? Average speed? 2 meters per second. So don't get confused because we have taken meters, not a kilometer. You don't get you erase that. So average speed how much? Average speed of that boy is equal to 2 meters per second. How much? 2 meters per second. Okay, this is average speed. Now we calculate average velocity. Second one, average velocity. See, average velocity and velocity both are same. Isn't it? Both mathematical formula same. You don't get confusion. So average velocity is equal to total displacement divided by total time taken. Okay? So average velocity is equal to total displacement divided by total time taken. Am I right? Yes. So what is the total displacement and what is total time? That is next question. Total displacement. Second one, total time. First one, what is that? Total displacement. Second one, total time. Okay, listen here. What is the total displacement? What is the total displacement? Listen here. You have to take out that boy starting point here. Okay, that boy starting point this one. Which means that boy's house. Then after 50 seconds. After 50 seconds, that boy reaches fruit shop. Alright, that boy reaches fruit shop. Okay, then again, next, okay, which means after 50 seconds, that boy comes to his house. Already, what is displacement?
What is displacement? The shortest distance between two points, which means shortest distance between initial position, final position. Am I right? Here, which is initial position and which is final position? So here, that boy again comes to his house. Am I right? So here, final position coincides with initial position. Am I right? Final position coincides with initial position. So whenever an object final position coincides with initial position, what about the displacement? Displacement becomes zero. Am I right? Here displacement becomes zero, isn't it? Because displacement is the shortest distance between two points. Here final point coincides with initial point. Okay, so displacement zero. Okay, first that boy moves from his house to that food stall. The distance how much? 100 meters. Yes, 100 meters. Okay, again that boy moves from food shop. Okay, from food shop to that boy house. Okay, his house. That is how much distance? That is same 100 meters. So 100 meter minus 100 meter, which is equal to zero. Okay, which means displacement zero. Why? Because here the final position of the boy coincides with initial position, due to which displacement becomes zero. Okay, the displacement becomes zero. But what is the total time? Do you think total time also becomes zero? That is not possible. Time never zero. Okay, time never zero. Maybe that quantity, displacement quantity may be zero, but time never zero. Okay, so what is the total time taken? Total time taken how much? That boy moves from his house to food shop. Okay, he has taken how much? 50 seconds. Again, that boy moves along the same path. That boy again takes 50 seconds. So 50 seconds plus 50 seconds is equal to 100 seconds. Yes. Total time? 100 seconds. Now substitute the both value in average speed formula. So average speed. Sorry, average velocity. Sorry. Average velocity is equal to total displacement. How much? Zero. Divided by then total time, that is 100 seconds. 100 seconds. Now what is the value here? Now what is the value? Then average velocity becomes zero. Okay, because numerator that is zero. So the average velocity becomes zero. So average velocity is equal to zero. Alright? Average velocity zero. But what is average speed? Look at here. Average speed is 2 meters per second. Okay, so average speed is 2 meters per second, whereas average velocity zero. So here speed and velocity are not always equal in magnitude. In some cases, speed and velocity magnitude will be same. But most of the cases, the speed and velocity magnitude will not be same. Isn't it? Will not be same. Okay, here the object covers, do you think it's only single straight line? That's not possible. First the boy moves towards east, again the boy comes towards west direction. Am I right? So final position points with initial position, due to which displacement zero. So whenever an object moves along double straight line, isn't it? Double straight line, then the speed and velocity will not be equal in magnitude. Isn't it very simple? In first case, the speed and velocity magnitude same. But in this case, in second case, speed and velocity magnitude is not same. Isn't it? Not same, because here the object does not move, okay, in a single straight path. Here the object moves along the double straight line, due to which here velocity becomes zero. Isn't it? Velocity becomes zero. Isn't it? So most of these cases, the speed and velocity magnitude will be same. But other some cases, the speed and velocity will not be same in the magnitude. Isn't it? It's a very easy one. So next we will see the differences. Okay, the difference between speed and velocity. What is speed and what is velocity, like that? Is it okay? Yes. Then after that we will see some numericals, which is based on velocity as well as speed.
speed. Okay, listen here. In this case, average velocity, what is that? Average velocity is 0. I'm right. So, average velocity, not average velocity, generally velocity. So, velocity can be 0. I'm right. Velocity can be 0. In what condition? So, whenever, okay, so whenever the final position of the points and the initial position, here become, displacement becomes 0. I mean, displacement becomes 0. If the displacement is 0, then velocity becomes 0. I mean, velocity becomes 0. Okay, time now is 0. Mark my word. Time now is 0. Okay. So next we'll see the differences between speed and velocity. Okay, so next topic, that is differences between speed and velocity. Okay, so first one speed, second one velocity. First one speed and second one velocity. Okay, what is the first point? What is speed? Speed means nothing but distance covered by an object per unit time. Alright, that is speed. So, speed, what is that? Distance covered by an object. Okay, distance covered by an object per unit time. Per unit time, that is speed. Whereas, what is velocity? Displacement covered by an object per unit time. Isn't it? Yes. Displacement covered by an object. Okay, displacement covered by an object per unit time. Okay, this is first point. Okay, this is the first difference between speed and velocity, that is distance covered by an object per unit time. This is first speed. Then velocity means displacement covered by an object per unit time. Okay, yes. Next, unit. What is unit? The unit of speed. Okay, so unit of speed, what is that? Meter per second. Alright, then what is the unit of velocity? That is also meter per second. Okay, so velocity unit also meter per second. Isn't it? So it is simple. Both speed and velocity unit same. Here. Okay, next one. Speed. That is vector quantity or scalar quantity. You tell me. Look at here, I'll give some shortcut. Yes. Okay. The speed, first letter, yes. Yes, which denotes scalar quantity. Okay, keep this in your mind. Yes, the first letter of speed is the word speed, that is yes. Yes denotes what is that? Scalar quantity. Okay. Here velocity. The first letter of the word velocity V. Okay, here V denotes what? Vector quantity, very easy. This is one of the shortcut method. Okay, don't get memorize. Okay, so speed is a what quantity? Speed is a scalar quantity. Speed is a scalar quantity. Speed is a scalar quantity. Whereas velocity is a vector quantity. It is a vector quantity. Velocity is a vector quantity because it has only magnitude, that is for direction. Velocity has both magnitude as well as direction. That's why it under the category of vector quantity. Okay, so this is third point. Fourth point, what is it? Speed. Okay, do you think speed becomes zero? Speed never zero. Whereas velocity can be zero. Okay, even last topic just now we have seen that case. Okay, here average velocity become zero. Okay, so speed never zero. Okay, speed never be zero.
Speed never be zero. Whereas velocity, velocity can be zero.
Velocity can be zero.
Okay, is very important 3-in-1 question. The difference between speed and velocity is very very important 3-mark question. Okay, first one, what is that? The display distance covered by an object, that is speed. Velocity, displacement covered by object, that is velocity. Next one, unit, the speed unit, that is meter per second, as well as velocity unit, that is also meter per second. And third one, speed, that is vector quantity, scalar quantity. Speed, that is a scalar quantity. Then velocity is a vector quantity. Then fourth one, speed. Speed never becomes zero. Speed never becomes zero. Whereas velocity can be zero. Okay, so these all are differences between speed and velocity. Isn't it? Speed and velocity, very easy one. This is very very important 3-mark question. Isn't it? Very very important 3-mark question. You read carefully. Okay, yes, that's all. Next one, numericals.
We will start numerical.
Okay, next, now we are going to solve numerical. This is based on average, okay, generally speed and velocity. Okay, we are going to see different types of numericals. Isn't it? Different types of numericals, yes. Now I am going to solve around 5 to 6 numericals. It is very very easy numerical. This is based on only speed and velocity, that's all. The first numerical, look at here, first numerical I am going to write on the board. Your car travels a distance of 200 km from Delhi
to Ambala.
From Delhi to Ambala towards north
in 5 hours.
5 hours. Calculate.
Calculate speed
and velocity. Okay, listen here. First numerical, a car travels a distance of how much? 200 km from Delhi to Ambala. Okay, from Delhi to Ambala. Ambala is one of the city. From Delhi to Ambala towards north direction. Towards north direction in 5 hours. In 5 hours, isn't it?
Yes.
Now calculate the speed and velocity. What is that? Speed. Second one, velocity. Okay. First, we will find out speed. Okay. First one, speed. Solution. Speed. Speed. What is speed formula? What is speed formula? Speed is nothing but the distance covered by an object. Okay, per unit time. That is speed. So we can write distance divided by time. Amare, distance divided by time. Distance how much here? Distance how much? 200 kilometers. Distance 200 kilometers. Time value how much? Time value how much? 5 hours. Time 5 hours. 5 hours. Okay, now find out the speed value. So speed is equal to distance divided by time. Distance 200 km divided by time 5 hours. 5 hours, which is equal to how much? This is equal to
40, this is equal to 40. So speed is equal to speed of the car, this is equal to how much? 40 kilometer per hour. What is the speed of the car, which is equal to how much? 40 kilometer per hour. Okay, okay, this is the form, this is the speed. Next you find out the velocity. So velocity is equal to, velocity is equal to what is that? Displacement divided by time taken. Yes. Displacement divided by time taken. Okay. So what is the displacement here? Displacement value and time value. Here, look at here. What is the displacement? Here, a car moves. Okay, I'm going to show the diagram. Look at here. A car moves. This is Delhi, yes, this is Delhi. Ambalas here. Okay, this is Delhi, this is Ambala. Okay, here the distance between Delhi and Ambala, this is 200 km. How much? 200 km. Isn't it 200 km? The car goes 200 km in 5 hours. In 5 hours. Time how much? 5 hours. Isn't it?
Yes.
The car moves towards what direction? North direction. So this is north direction. This is south direction. Here the car moves from Delhi to Ambala. Alright, this is north. From Delhi to Ambala towards north direction. Isn't it? Here what is the displacement? Displacement is equal to 200 km towards north direction. Because the car moves towards north direction. Isn't it?
Yes.
So displacement is equal to 200 km. Towards north. Okay, that is displacement. Next one, time. Time same 5 hours. Time same 5 hours. Now find out the velocity. So velocity, which is equal to displacement over time. Displacement value 200 km towards east. Sorry, north. Towards north. Divided by time. Time 5 hours. 5 hours. Okay, you further divide both, you can get 40. This is equal to 40. So velocity, it is equal to 40 km per hour. Okay, towards? Towards north. Alright. Velocity is equal to how much? 40 km per hour towards north. Okay, look at here. Here the magnitude of the speed is equal to magnitude of the velocity. Am I right? Because here the car, which means that the object moves only single straight line. Am I right? Only single straight line. So that is the reason why here the velocity, the speed, the quantity, magnitude of the speed is equal to magnitude of the velocity. So this is the one of the type of the numerical. This is based on speed as well as velocity. Isn't it very simple? Okay, this is the first numerical. Is it understood?
Yes.
Next we will see another one. Okay, another numerical. Next you will see, next numerical, second numerical. I am going to write the question on the board. Look at here. Yeah, bus covers. Yeah, bus covers a distance of. Yeah, bus covers a distance of 250 km. From Delhi to Jaipur. From Delhi to Jaipur towards west. Towards west in 5 hours. In 5 hours. 5 hours in the morning and returns to Delhi. Returns to Delhi in the evening. Covering the same distance of 250 kilometers in the same time of. In the same time of 5 hours. Now you find out the average speed and average velocity. Okay, find average speed, then average velocity. Okay, listen here. I'm reading this question. Look at here. A bus covers a distance of 250 kilometer from Delhi to Jaipur towards west direction in 5 hours. Time how much? 5 hours. In the morning and again returns to Delhi in the evening to covering the same distance. Okay, note this point. Same distance of 250 kilometer. Okay, so in the same time of 5 hours. Okay, 5 hours. Okay, here the both time taken same. Okay, to reach Jaipur from Delhi, again from Jaipur to Delhi, that object has taken same time, that is 5 hours. Okay, for going, again coming, that is also 5 hours, isn't it? Now you find out average speed and average velocity. That is a question. Okay, so find first, start with average speed. Solution. First one, average speed. What is it? Average speed. Average speed formula: total distance covered by an object divided by total time taken plus total distance divided by total time. Isn't it? Yes. Listen here. Consider this is Delhi. Delhi is here. Then Jaipur. Jaipur is here. Okay, the distance between Delhi and Jaipur. Distance between Delhi and Jaipur, that is how much? 250 kilometer. Here the bus covers the distance of 250 km from Delhi to Jaipur towards your direction, towards west. So this is west direction. Alright? So this is west direction. Towards west in 5 hours. Okay, time taken 5 hours. Okay. So this is in the morning. Again the bus moves along the same path of 250 kilometers. From Jaipur to Delhi. Okay, here also the bus has taken same time. That is how much? 5 hours. Okay, this also 5 hours. So 250 kilometer, 5 hours. Okay, now what is the total distance? Total distance. So total distance is equal to how much? Okay, from Delhi to Jaipur, that bus has taken 5 hours, the distance 250 km. Yes, 250 km. Again the bus moves along the same path of 250 km from Jaipur to Delhi. Am I right? Yes. So this also 250 km. So total distance how much? 250 km plus 250 km is equal to 500 km. It is equal to 500 km. Okay. The time taken how much? Total time how much? Okay, that bus has taken 5 hours to reach Jaipur from Delhi. Again, okay, this is the morning. Again in the evening, that bus has taken again same 5 hours to reach Delhi from Jaipur. Okay, so 5 hours plus 5 hours is equal to 10 hours. So 5 hours. Okay, 5 hours for going from Delhi to Jaipur. Okay, again 5 hours for coming from Jaipur to Delhi. So 5 hours plus 5 hours is equal to 10 hours.
Now find out the average speed.
So average speed is equal to how much?
This formula, total distance,
500 kilometers divided by then what the time? How much?
10 hours.
10 hours.
Which is equal to what?
10 hours is equal to what?
5.
So 50 kilometer per hour. That is speed. So average speed is equal to 50 kilometers per hour. Okay, that bus average speed is equal to 50 kilometers per hour. Isn't it?
Yes.
Now find out the average velocity. Isn't it? Average velocity. Second one. Average velocity. What is average velocity formula?
Average velocity formula, total displacement divided by total time taken.
That is, yes, total displacement divided by total time taken. Am I right? Total displacement divided by total time taken. That is the formula for average velocity. What is the total displacement? Total displacement, how much? What is the total time taken? Listen here. So this is a diagram. Look at here. First, that bus starts its journey from Delhi to Jaipur. Okay, so that bus covers the distance of 250 km from Delhi to Jaipur in 5 hours. Alright? This is in the morning. Again, in the evening, that bus returns from Jaipur to Delhi. Isn't it? Jaipur to Delhi along the distance of 250 km. Same 250 km. Okay, in the time of 5 hours. Alright? So okay, which is initial point and which is final point of the bus. So this is the initial point of the bus. Okay, after 5 hours, the bus reaches Jaipur. Isn't it? This is the morning. Again, after 5 hours, that bus again comes to Delhi. Alright? So here, final position of the bus coincides with initial position. Alright? Final position of the bus coincides with initial position. So, what is the displacement? Displacement becomes zero. Okay, displacement becomes zero. So, already we know. So, whenever the final position of the object coincides with initial position, then there will be displacement zero. Alright, displacement zero. So, here also displacement zero. Okay, so here the bus covers 250 km from Delhi to Jaipur. 250 km. Again the bus comes to Jaipur to Delhi along the same distance of 250 km. Okay, so 250 km minus 250 km is equal to 0. 250 km, which is equal to 0. Okay, but what is the time here? What is the time? Time 10 hours. Okay, time 10 hours, because the bus has taken 5 hours to reach Jaipur from Delhi. Again the bus has taken 5 hours to reach Delhi from Jaipur. So 5 hours plus 5 hours is equal to 10 hours. So time 5 hours plus 5 hours is equal to 10 hours.
10 hours,
isn't it?
Yes.
So remaining are right here. So average velocity is equal to what is that? Total displacement divided by total time taken. Total displacement value 0. So 0 divided by time value 10 hours. 10 hours. This is equal to what? This is equal to 0. Because here look at that, the numerator is 0. So then the average velocity becomes 0. So average velocity 0. What is that? Average velocity becomes 0. Very simple. Okay? Here the average speed of the bus 50 km per hour. Okay, that is speed. Next, yawne velocity, that is zero. Why? Because displacement zero. Here, final portion of the bus coincides with initial portion due to this displacement zero. So, if the displacement zero, then yawne velocity becomes zero. Okay, this is the second type of numerical, isn't it? Yes. Next, third numerical. We will see next numerical. Okay, third numerical. Listen, get third one. A car travels along a straight road to the east, for 120 meters in 5 seconds. Then go for west. Then goes the west for 60 meters in 1 second. Determine the average speed. Determine the average speed and average velocity. Okay, so listen. Listen here. A car travels along a straight road to the east. Okay, east direction for 120 meters. How much? 120 meters, okay, 120 meters in 5 seconds. Time how much? In 5 seconds.
Yes.
Then the car goes the west direction for 60 meters in 1 second. How much in 1 second? Determine the average speed and average velocity. Okay, average speed and average velocity. Okay, listen there. Consider one car, this car. Consider car. The car starting point is, if this is considered this A, that is for a convenient. Okay? The car starting point is this A. Okay. Next, the car goes towards east direction. Which is east direction? This is east direction. For 120 kilometers. Like this. The car goes 120 kilometers. Okay, now car comes this. This is point B. Okay, what is the distance between from A to B? How much? 120 meters. Okay, this 120 meters. Okay, listen here. Here, the car has taken 5 seconds to reach 120 meters from point A to point B. Okay, point A to point B. Okay, time how much? 5 seconds. 5 seconds. Okay, yes. So this is what direction? This is east direction. Okay, the car moves towards this direction. Then opposite to east direction, this is west direction. This is west direction. Am I right?
Yes.
Next, look at here. Next, the car go west direction. It means the car moves along the same path. Okay, for 60 meters. Okay, comes here now. The car comes here. Now the car comes here. Press this point C. This is the point C. Okay, the car go the best for 60 meter in 1 second. So the car comes to this point. Okay, for point C in 1 second. How much? In 1 seconds. The distance how much? 60 meter. Now this is 60 meters. Okay, can you see this clearly? 60 meter. Isn't it? Yes. Now you find out average speed and average velocity. Average velocity. Okay, listen here. Consider one car. That car starts journey from point A. This point A. Isn't it? Yes. The car moves for 120 meters. 120 meters towards east direction. This is east direction. So the car comes to position B. Isn't it? So here the car has taken 5 seconds to reach point B from A. Isn't it? Yes. Again the car moves along the same path. The car comes to position C. Okay, so the car covers is 60 meters. Then the car comes to position C. Here the car covers the 60 meters towards west direction. This direction in 1 second. In 1 second, isn't it? Yes. Now you find out the average speed and average velocity. Okay, first we will find out average speed. What is that? That is average speed. Average speed is equal to formula. What is that? Total distance covered by an object divided by total time taken. Yes. Total distance divided by total time. Total time. So what is total distance here? Total distance how much? Then total time how much? Okay, listen here. Total time is my first one. Total distance. If this total distance, that car starts going from point A. Then after that, move towards point B. Okay, so AB is equal to how much? AB value how much? AB is equal to how much? 120 meters. Am I right? AB is equal to 120 meters. So AB plus, again the car comes to position C. Okay, look at here. The car, when the car goes west direction, 60 meters in 1 second. Again the car moves along the same path. The car comes to position C. The distance is how much? 60 meters. So BC. Isn't it? BC. It is equal to total distance. It is equal to AB plus BC. Okay, so what is AB value? Okay, AB value how much? AB is equal to 120 meters. Yes, 120 meters. Then BC is equal to how much? BC 60 meters. Yes, 60 meters. Okay, now total distance is equal to AB plus BC. Is equal to how much? Total distance is equal to 120 plus 60. How much? 180. 120 meter plus 60 meter is equal to 180 meters. Total distance 180 meters. Yes. Total time how much? Look at here. Total time how much? The car covers the distance from distance of 120 meter from point A to B in 5 seconds. So AB is equal to 5 seconds. Yes. 5 seconds plus again the car moves along the same path, comes to position C. That is how much? The car has taken 1 second. Okay, 1 second to reach point C from point B. So 1 second. So 5 seconds plus 1 second is equal to 6 seconds. Yes, total time is equal to 6 seconds. Okay, now substitute these all values. So average speed, which is equal to what is that? Total distance divided by total time. Total distance how much? 180 meters. 180 meters divided by time 6 seconds. 6 seconds. What is the value? Okay, 6 into 3. 6 into 3, 18. So this is equal to 30 meters per second. So average speed average speed is equal to 30 meters per second.
Look at that. Average speed of how much? Average speed how much?
30 meters per second.
That is average speed of the car. Okay.
Yes.
Now you find out the average velocity. Now you find out the average velocity.
Okay.
Yes. This is okay. Okay. I'm going to write here. Okay. No, I like that. Okay, I'll start here. This diagram is very important. Okay. Now find average velocity. So average velocity is equal to, what is the formula? Average velocity, total displacement divided by total time taken.
Yes,
total displacement divided by total time. Total time. Okay. Yes. Yeah. What is the displacement? Total displacement. Look at here, total displacement. Here, first the car starts its journey from point A. Then after 5 seconds, it covers 120 meters. Okay. Then again the car moves along the same path. Then come to position C. Okay. Again the car goes 60 meters distance in 1 second. Okay. Here the car which is in position C. The car is in position C. Okay. So already we know what is displacement. The shortest distance between two points. Okay. Shortest distance between initial point and final point. Here this is initial point of the car. A is the initial point of the car. And final position. C is the final position. Now the car is in position C. Am I right?
Yes.
Cool. So what is the displacement? Okay, what is the distance between A and C towards this direction? What is this? Okay, what is the distance here? Okay, so we don't know. We don't know the distance value between A and C. Distance value between A and C. Okay, whereas we know the distance value of A and B, then B and C. Am I right? So if you subtract, okay, so if you minus the value of AB minus BC, we can get the value of AC. Am I right?
Yes.
So here, AC, this is total displacement, AC. Okay, so this is initial point, this is final point. So we need this distance. Okay, so the total displacement AC is equal to AB minus BC. Okay, because we know the AB value and BC value. Okay, so if we subtract the value of AB minus BC, we can get the value of AC. Is it? Why? Because this is the initial position of the car and this is the final position of the car. Okay, already we know the displacement, what is that? The shortest distance between initial point and final point. Isn't it?
Yes.
So AB value how much? 120 meters minus BC value 60 meters. So 120 minus 60 is equal to 60 meters.
Yes.
60 meters. So total displacement which is equal to 60 meters. Okay.
Yes.
Next one, what is total time? What is the total time? Listen here. The car moves. Okay, the car starts journey from point A and after 5 seconds, the car comes to position B. Okay, time how much?
5 seconds.
Yes, 5 seconds. Again, the car moves on the same path and comes to position C. Now the car has taken 1 second, just 1 second to come to position C from B. Okay, so plus
1 second.
So what is the total time? 5 seconds plus 1 second is equal to 6 seconds.
Yes,
I'll rub this. Okay, total time how much? 6 seconds. So total time 6 seconds. Isn't it?
Yes.
So now substitute these two values in this equation. So average velocity
average velocity, which is equal to total distance divided by total time taken. Total distance how much? 60 meters. 60 meters divided by the total time taken, 6 seconds, which is equal to how much? 10 meters per second. So average velocity, which is equal to 10 meters per second. Okay, average velocity how much? 10 meters per second. Very easy one, isn't it? Yes. So this is one of the method, one of the method of numerical is based on speed and velocity, isn't it? Yes, very simple. I'd like to come here first one. Okay, next one. So next numerical. This is the fourth numerical. A truck driver drives 20 kilometer down the road in 5 minutes. He then reverses and drives 12 kilometer back down the road in 3 minutes. So what is his average velocity? What is his average velocity? That is question. Look at here, solution. Is it here? A truck driver drives 20 kilometer. How much? 20 kilometers down the road in 5 minutes. And 5 minutes, he then reverses and drives 12 kilometer back. Again, back. Down the road in 3 minutes. So what is his average velocity? What is his average velocity? Okay, consider one truck. Okay, the truck driver drives the truck 20 kilometers down the road. Okay, so this is starting point. Consider A is the starting point of the truck. Next, the driver drives the car down to the road 20 kilometers. Now the truck comes to position B. Isn't it? The distance between A and B, that is 20 kilometers. Okay, so here the driver has taken how much time? 5 minutes to drive the car from point A to point B to cover the distance of 20 kilometers. Isn't it? Time 5 minutes. Okay? Yes. Then reverse. Who reverse the car? Driver. The driver reverse the car. Okay. 12 kilometers. Okay, 12 kilometers back. Okay, again the truck moves in the same path. Okay, how much distance? 12 kilometers. So the car the truck comes to position C along the same path.
Isn't it along
same path? Okay, here the truck has taken how much? 3 minutes. 3 minutes to cover the 12 kilometers. 12 kilometers, your truck has taken 3 minutes. How much? 3 minutes.
Okay, now you find out the average distance and average.
Sorry,
now you find out only average velocity.
The average velocity. Average velocity is equal to what is the formula? Total displacement. Total displacement divided by total time. Amari total time. What is total displacement? First one, total. First one, what is the total displacement? Look at it here. What is the total displacement here? The car starts journey from point A. Amari point A. Then after 5 minutes, the car comes to position B. Okay, here the car goes the distance of 20 kilometers. Amari 20 kilometers. Yes. Again, the car moves along the same path, covers the distance of 12 kilometers in 3 minutes. 12 kilometers in 3 minutes here. Okay, so now the car is in position C, not in position B. Again, car moves along the same path and comes to position C. So, which is initial position, final position of the truck? This is initial position of the truck and this is final position of the truck. So this is a total displacement. Okay, the shortest distance between two points, initial point, final point. This is the point, final point. This is displacement. Am I right? So we need this value. But we don't know. We don't know the value of AC. But we know AB and BC. Am I right? So if we subtract the value of AB with BC, we can get the value of AC. Am I right?
Yes.
So total displacement is equal to AB minus BC. Minus BC. Am I right? So AB will be how much? AB 20 kilometers. 20 kilometers minus BC value 12 kilometers. 12 kilometers. So 20 minus 12 is equal to 8. So total displacement 8. Total displacement is equal to 8 kilometers. What is that? 8 kilometers. Okay. Then what is the total time? What is the total time given here? Total time. The car, since earlier, the truck starts journey from point A and after 5 minutes, the car comes to position B. And again, the car moves along the same path, comes to position C. The car has taken 3 minutes. So here, 5 minutes for AB and 3 minutes for BC. So this is the final question. So what is the total time? Total time is equal to how much? 5 minutes plus 3 minutes. So it is equal to 8 minutes. Am I right? So total time is equal to 8 minutes. Now substitute the both value in that formula. We can get average velocity. Yes. So average velocity is equal to total displacement how much? 8 kilometer divided by 8 kilometer divided by total time again? 8 minutes. 8 minutes. So this is equal to what is that? 1. 8 is cancelled. So this is equal to 1. So 1 kilometer per minutes. So average velocity of a truck
how much? 1 kilometer per minute. Okay, the truck covers 1 kilometer in 1 minute. That is a minute, isn't it? So this is one of the type of numerical based on average velocity. Okay, so today's class getting over. So in this class we have discussed so many things. I mean, what is speed, what is velocity, the differences between speed and velocity, then magnitudes between speed and velocity, then under what condition the magnitude of the speed will be equal to magnitude of the velocity, and so many things. Am I right? So in this class we have discussed so many things. Actually, it will be very useful, helpful for you. So in ninth physics, the most of the questions will be only numerical. Okay, out of 100%, around 60-70% will be only numericals. So you must concentrate. Okay, more than okay. okay, it's more than theory, only in numericals. So that's why I'm giving more importance for numericals, isn't it? You solve lots of numericals, you get the numericals from internet and so many other sources, isn't it? You need lots of practice, so generally you can get a good marks, okay, in the 90s, isn't it? It's a very easy one. You try to understand the concept, you don't memorize anything. If you understand the concept, the all numericals will be easy for you, isn't it? Yes, okay, so today we are getting over. Thank you. We'll see next class. Okay, thank you.